The God of the Lord of hosts, the God of hosts. Is it because there's nothing like Chineke Nkusu Kendaga. There's nothing like God. Eke no nuchi unyama inaka ngungu di no besebo aga. Ise chubangwa isi njidengwa anaka. Oh, how I wish my people will understand how all these things have been played out or happening. All right, so what's up, family and friends? Welcome to the Woke Nation, our nation of factual truth, where we feel free to spread the knowledge or share and spread the knowledge of factual truth without fear, without favor, and without faint. Of course, this truth must prevail, and we will not give up until the truth prevail. And I am happy, even happier, that our people are waking up. I saw this clip I shared. You see, Roman Catholic Church members that locked out their Reverend Father and they chased him away. See, let me play it. So these are Christians. They lock out the Reverend Father. Okay, see where they chase him away. See, Pora in a church, they chase the Reverend Father away. Listen, whether you want to listen to what we are saying or not, people are waking up, directly or indirectly. Time is coming when we begin to demolish churches in our villages. Villages, I'm not even talking about cities, in the villages, because village is where religion really have stronghold. Those people you see in the city, their root is in the village. Is what they came to that city from, whatever they were indoctrinated or brainwashed with in the village. You see them going Pentecostal church in the city, but in the village they go to Roman Catholic church, they go to Anglican church or some other old churches in the village. So they are religious people to the core. You see, no matter their position in the society, in the city or in abroad, but the village, that thing from the village, if you see anyone that grew up in the village, it is hard for them to leave their belief. I did not grow up all my life in the village. I grew up in the village and in the city. You see that? So, but if you see those ones that were born and bred in the village, man, it's hard for them to leave their belief, no matter what. They will say, yeah, what you are saying is true, but that village thing, they will never leave it. They grew up with it. Okay? So, because they're confused, it made them confused. I want to share what is very important. I'll be playing another video about what happened in Oga. Oga was a place. I was in Oga last month, you know, so that's where the place I also met the native doctor, one of the good native doctors I met, which I will still share his video. And he's an outspoken person, and he got some information that we need also, especially about all these people of claiming that Igbo people are Jews. You know, you're supposed to know why. Why white people keep saying that Igbo people are Jews or all that. Okay, you will know it's power stuff. I mean, it power stuff. That's it. Okay, so they want to get it, but they cannot. That power is with us. White people cannot take our power. They can take the artifacts, they can take other things, but you see that power. That power is in us. We have to trust whatever they give to us so that we can restore that power. That power cannot die. That power is like energy. It doesn't die. It's there in us. They don't have it, and they cannot have it unless they're with us. Then they use us to enjoy it, but they cannot have it. They cannot operate it. That's what I mean. It is Africans that we operate it. So I titled this book of the law. Okay, so, and when you say this book of the law, I mean the Bible, I mean Quran, I mean Torah. I mean the religious book, the book they used to brainwash us. You know, we hang on this book. That's why I want to play that Oga video. Because except the second person that spoke, which is elderly man, he's the only one that said they use scientific and the traditional way methods to find to catch the guy. But others were saying, God, thank God, by the grace of God, bullshit. See, God, we have God problem. Now, God let that young man kill that young pregnant woman. God did not save her life. But these people are talking about God. Say they catch this guy by the grace of God. Where was the grace of God when he killed that young pregnant woman? Our people are supposed to think. That's what I'm doing. I want you to think. You believe that God is the one that made them to catch that young man. Where was that God when that young man was killing the girl? If that God exists, just think. Huh? Why is it every time this God forget to do certain things, and you know, you remember to do certain things, and you say, yeah, he did this one. Okay, but he forgot to do this one. But you say, no, it's everywhere. It does not exist. So this book of the law, that's how they enslave us. We have it as a problem. I used to live by this book of the law, but I stopped using it. And those people that are telling you, they leave their Bible, they say, this book of the law. They will also tell you that Christ has set them free from the bondage of the law. But they are still following the book of the law, the Ten Commandments, collecting tithes and offering. Is in the book of the law. They claim that Christ has said, he said, if you are still following the law, you have fallen from grace. So, but the truth is this, that grace brought disgrace to Africa. Whatever they promise to Africa, all of them are lies. It's something they promise you to have over your dead body, not while you are alive. So this book of the law, it says in Joshua chapter 1, verse 8, you know, Oyedepo always love to quote this place when they want to talk about prosperity gospel or success. You know, God will make you have success. They always go to this. Why? They are followers of Jesus Christ, who has fulfilled the law, abolished the law. According to them, according to Paul epistle or Pauline epistles, as they said in theological school, they tell you that Christ has fulfilled the law, has paid all the price. Now, if you are living under the law, you are living under curse. You are living under curse, because if you keep the 99 of the law and the fair and one, or 9 of the law and fair and one, you are fed all. So you will still be punished. You see that bullshit. But these people, when they want to talk about success, prosperity, they go to Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. Hear what he says. Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. He said, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth." There is no pastor that don't cram this part of the Bible. They cram it in their head. Every serious Christian must cram this Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. This book, oh, he said, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night." You see why they use it to pray day and night, morning devotion, night prayer, day and night. You must meditate, you must preach, you must teach, you must meditate on it, in it, day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in, do according to all that is written in it. Whether you have it Old Testament and New Testament, or only Old Testament, or only, say you must observe to do according to all, not some, all that is written in it. I haven't seen them and putting their hands and plugging up their eyes, as Jesus said. Jesus said, if your eyes makes you to fall into trap, instead the eyes will cause you to lose heaven. Plug it out. Instead your hand will cause you, cut it up. Have you seen them? No, they don't practice that part. Have you seen them selling everything they have and giving it to the poor and following Jesus? No. But they quote it. "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then, when will these people have life? When will these people have prosperity? When will these people have success? For then you will make your way prosperous." You see why they devote themselves into what the Bible says. This is it. He said, when you observe to do all the Bible said by you, meditating on it, he said, then you will make your way prosperous. Who don't want to have prosperity? And then you will have good success. Who don't want to have good success? Oh, it is easier this way. I don't have to walk. All I have to do is to not let the book of the law depart from my mouth, that's the Bible, and observe all things according to what is written there. But they pick it, they only cherry pick it. They pick the things they want from the Bible that represent all things. In other words, when you take a portion of the Bible as the truth, it represents other parts of the Bible. So you ignore them. The ones that say, you grow those ones. This one you have, that is the all. No, you cannot. Part of the Bible cannot be all the Bible. So if you are observing part and not all, you are not observing. That's why it's not working for you. You are the one making your way prosperous with your knowledge, with your skill, not with anything written in the Bible. No, you cannot demonstrate it. "No weapon fashioned against me shall prosper." Go and try it now. They just say, "Pah!" You begin to run. You run for your life. But they say, "No weapon fashioned against you shall prosper." Why are you running? Why are you praying against any evil coming on you? He said, "Evil shall not befall you." He said, "Plague shall not come near your dwelling." Why are you wearing mask? Why are you afraid like every other person? I want you to know that the book of the law was written by the slave master for the slaves. The slave masters compiled the Bible to control their slaves. The slave masters compiled Quran to control their slaves. The slave masters compiled Torah to control their slaves. The men, we don't need any law to live by. All we have to live is natural, live humanly. You don't, law is man-made, every law. You, whether you call it law of nature or law of God, it is man that made up that bullshit. And the law is, was made to be broken too. Don't live under any law unless it's serving for your own good. If it's not everybody doing it, why are you the one doing it? Why when they made the law, is some people that is under the law? You say nobody is above the law. Where is that? People that made the law is above the law. Is Trump not above the law now? He's still the president because he's above the law. The House impeached him, but the Senate refused to impeach him. So he's still remaining in power, but he's impeached by the House. That is the law. Now he refused to concede defeat, right? Okay, but according to Constitution of America, on the 20th of January, they will swear in whoever people voted in, whether he like it or not. He can go to Supreme Court all he wants. The people have spoken, right? Okay, so but if you follow what has been happening in his administration, you see, the man has been above the law. There's nothing, collusion was there, he's still there. They jailed his own lawyer, whom he sent to do what made that lawyer get jailed. But they say you cannot indict a sitting president. But you believe the lie they told you that no man is above the law. The people that tell you no man is above the law say that you cannot jail their sitting president. So that sitting president is above the law. See? Think. Okay, let me go back. He said that if you don't let the book of the law depart from your mouth, so you have to be preaching it, even when you don't know, when you don't understand it. Because the book of the law was written for you not to understand it. It's for you to just need a guide to guide you. So that's why they created those priests or those rabbis or those scribes, those pastors, to be teaching you bullshit, interpreting it. Have you seen two pastors that interpret a portion of scripture the same way? No. They always disagree among themselves because it was written as a purpose. It was written as an absolute. It was written for you to not understand it. Hard to understand. And that's why I see some of our people say that Bible is like a forest. You enter forest, you can wander away, you cannot know everything in the forest. That's bullshit. A book written by somebody that you can spend time to read from cover to cover, you are telling me you cannot understand it. The book of the law was written by the slave master for the slaves. The book of the law was written by the rich for the control of the poor. The rich few compile it to control the poor masses, the whole masses. And anyone that rebel against it, they say it's God that will punish you, but that the one that will punish you, put you in jail, kill you. Many people have been killed because of the Bible. Because they say no to Bible, they kill them. But they say it's the book of the law of God. The God that is taking, that wrote this book is man. The God that will punish anyone that disobey what is in this book is man. Which God are they talking about? This silly, stupid God of Israel that cannot do anything. Cannot show up here. And they are talking about that God. There is no God that gave law at any time to any man for any people. Let me say it again. There is no God that gave law at any time to any man for any people. No, God gave the word to Moses. Bullshit. God gave his word to Israel. Bullshit. It's all lies. Moses never existed. Israel never existed until 1948 when the Americans begin to build it. Mm-hmm. America is the real God of Israel. I want you to know that it was man that created God. The same man that created God made God incorporeal. That is, he made God invisible, telling you you cannot see God. How can you tell me I cannot see God? And this God is real. He says he's almighty. If God is almighty, that's all powerful, why is it impossible for this God to show up? This God that you say created me. No, it is man. It was man that created God and made God invisible. Not only that, that same man made the law of God for the control of the poor, desperate, and gullible people. Everybody is not under this book of the law. I used to be under it. Now I'm no longer under it. My life is far better now than when I was under this book of the law. If it were when I was under this book of law, I would not be fresh like this. I would be so looking haggard and looking like, come on, don't you eat well? Because I've been fasting and praying every week. Fasting and praying for what? When I'm supposed to be walking and resting, I am fasting and praying. It's walking and resting. That's what it's supposed to do. That's the only way you can take get care of yourself. You walk, you rest, you walk, you rest. That's it. I am walking now. After this, I will rest. And I do what I do to rest. You can't stop me. Slaves are poor. Slaves are desperate. Slaves are gullible. You can say they are rich. They are still slaves. Rich slave. Doctor, a slave. Engineer, a slave. President, a slave. Your position doesn't change who you are or what you are. It doesn't. Slaves are poor. That's why they have fear of God. They are poor. They are desperate and they are gullible. So they have fear of God. And they tell them the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. They say, okay, fear. There is no wisdom in fear. There is no knowledge in fear. There is no goodness in fear. There is no good thing in fear. They tell you fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. And you believe that bullshit. It's not. The fear of God is the cementing of bondage, the beginning and the crowning of bondage. The fear of God is accepting bondage. The fear of God is accepting evil as normal. These people have fear of God. They also have illusion of God, false belief of God. Instead of them seeing themselves as God, they say, no, there is another God. Although I cannot see, no, you are the God. You are the real God. There is no God in heaven. There is no God in your heart. There is no God in the Bible. There is no God in any book. There is no God in any temple. You are the God. God exists in no temple. Man built temple, including this one you call temple. There is no God in it. Man built it. Your father have sex with your mother, and your mother conceived and brought you forth. That's how you came into existence. That's why you celebrate your birthday. Have you celebrated your creation day? Because creation is a lie. Yes. Just a meteor. They have fear of God. They have illusion of God. And they have obsession of God. They're obsessed with God. Quoting the so-called Bible, the word of God. It says word of God. They must be quoting it. So the book of the law must not depart from your mouth. You want to have prosperity and good sources? Let the book of the law be in your mouth. Then he said, you meditate therein so that you can observe what is written therein. So you see them thanking the so-called God. You tell us, you hear the man that said that, you know, I am mourning, I am grieving, but they say we should thank God. Come to use your own brain, use your own mind. You are suffering. Somebody say, deny, say you are not suffering. No, I'm suffering. Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. They are telling you to lie. And the same book will tell you, you shall not bear false witness. But they tell you by faith, you can lie. If you believe in God, lie is acceptable. That's why they accept that. Okay, murder is bad, but if it's in the name of God, it's acceptable. They are obsessed. You see them quoting the so-called word of God, thanking the so-called God, and fighting anyone who disbelieves their illusion, who disbelieves their delusion, who disbelieves their hallucination about God and the Bible, God and the book. Their God is paper God, and they have become paper people. Their religion is book religion. You have to meditate in what is written there to observe everything. You have to meditate there, day and night. Meditate in it, day and night, that you may observe according to all that is written in it. And He said, this God, my God is with me. God is with me. If God is with you, what are you doing with the book? Do your own biological father that is alive speak to you through a book? And in this time and age, when we have phone, God is still speaking to you through a book. What happened to your phone? Your God cannot have phone number. Man made it, and your God cannot use it. And you're telling me your God is real. You keep talking God. I hate it when I'm listening to my people and they begin to mention God. God. Have you seen this God? No. Shut up! You're just saying the nonsense they beat into you from childhood. The book of the law is the book of the lies that there is God. They lie to you, telling you there is God without goddess or woman, but this God without God, without a goddess, without woman, has a son. And this son is himself. He sent his son and killed his son to save people he made. Oh, man. To save people he made. The God that have ability to make people could not save people without killing his son. This is a lie. This is lies they make you believe from that book of the law. They tell you the lie. There is God. And they tell you anyone, it's the fool that says inside there is no God. Laugh from that fool. That fool is wise. That fool tells you the truth. As I always say, if you are drowning in the river and the fool comes to save you, won't you allow him to save you? You say yes. When the fool tell you there is no God, he's telling you the truth to save you from the bondage of Christianity, to save you from the bondage of Islam, to save you from the bondage of Judaism, to save you from the bondage of religion, so that you can be yourself. Think for yourself. Imagine you are suffering. Somebody say, tell you are not suffering, so that God will bless you. Say you are not suffering, so that blessing will come. That's bullshit. Lie cannot bring any good thing to you. Anything that lie brings to you will not last. And at the end, it will make your life more miserable. It's like somebody saying he's drinking alcohol so that his problem will end. No way. When you finish drinking that alcohol will make you so intoxicated that you will hurt yourself more. You will wake up with bruises. You don't know how you get it because you are drunk. It adding to your problem. It cannot solve your problem. That's exactly what religion does. That's why they give you promise, not proof. That's why they give you prayer, not proof. That's why they give you poison, not proof. If you don't believe what we say, you will die. I pray God will do this. I promise you God will show himself to you. That's lie. That's bullshit. The book of the law is the book of the lies. That there is God without a goddess or woman, but this God has a son which is himself, who he killed to save those he made. If you believe it. Remember, they say he sent his son to die for you. But you are not saved now unless you believe. You must believe. So his death is useless. If you say he died for my sin, so why are you still holding me responsible for any sin? Why are you telling me if I don't believe, I will die, I am condemned? No, it doesn't make sense. He didn't die for me. No one can die for another person. Jesus cannot die for me. Jesus cannot die for you. I want you to know that it is your belief that makes life, that gives God life and the power. Without you believing in the content of the Bible is useless. You are the one that is making Bible be anything. You are the one, your belief is what making Bible, Quran or Torah be anything. It's nothing. Toilet roll is better than them. And the only useful Bible can be to you is to use it to clean your ass after you defecate or after you shit. That's the only thing it can help you. Or you can use it, sometimes it's a good reason, like some of them. You can use it to wrap your marijuana, your weed, and smoke it good. Or you can use it to tie something. It's paper made from the tree. It's not any God. There's no power in the Bible. There's no power in God. It is your belief that gives Bible or God the power. So understand that the Bible is what makes people confuse people. And I want to play and see how to show you how confused our people are. Instead of them to praise themselves for their effort and resources, they are ascribing it to one stupid God. And you know, they tell them you don't share it, so they always put him on top. Okay. So let me play it, all right, and conclude with that. This happened on August. So one of my friends on Facebook, yeah, I wanted to meet her, you know, that when I was last month, but we couldn't meet. So, but we still communicate on Facebook. Then she's the one that first alerted me on this. One day we were chatting, she said, everybody's hiding in Oga. You say, yeah, one woman was killed. I think, you know, many people will still come in, they say, maybe the husband killed the woman. You know, when something happened in Africa, Africans say a lot of things. Sometimes they kill innocent person for that. They accuse you for what you have not, the crime you have not committed. And you see them kill you. Sometimes they burn you to ashes, or they kill you, or they chase you out of the community. Just by mere allegation, nobody carried out investigation to find out the truth. But see this one, you know, the same thing happened. There were even women, they said they wanted to kill their husband. He's the one responsible for her death, until they catch the guy that actually killed the woman. So I want to play it. That's where I begin to see them talking about God. I get upset. It's nonsense. So I want to play it. You also, you can make your own judgment about it.
November 2020. Tomorrow, Saturday, precisely. Based on the crucial murder, that woman able to go to Oga. Based on that woman able to go to Oga, sometime again, to my the security offensive and Oga, the North Base, who are they where is Israel, Israel and Oga, where is. But fortunately enough, we are able to get a young man who is directly or indirectly involved in the crime. Forget about every other story, but we are here to tell you what happened. Kayamana Ihemeno. This guy is directly or indirectly involved. I'm so big a guy.
Before, anything will cry, and I never came here before.
ole. Then we should be a police station for the first time. Can you be a police station, Jimmy? Behind him is one of his deputies.
Now listen.
Because DJ and D Utoga, he'll be here, man. Anyway.
Okay. Come go and I'm naked. Let you naked. When you're massive, you know. You can start to work an MPG. Oga. Reason you say I can start to work an MPG. Oga. Bona. Why no need to have man? Oga. A lot of things can the man go against him. Oga. When the security, when the government in that. Oga. I'm wondering why you're. Underground, Roboro. I fire Boro Ama. I brought PG and I permission, but die of woman. And don't go to PG and I'm Robert Sierra. I come at the Edibera for the Veto. Macana has an honor of Akubani Gratuan Numero Logrozo. Akubani Gratuan Numero Logrozo. Where do we get the case? Where may I case in me by the grace of God? Tina Kenyaka, well, then to Yaka Twist, we would want my dear through the help of the youth. So, the end of the was the police, yeah, and the full details.
30 seconds.
No, listen.
Why he will equip now? I'm a one, you're getting the shop. I won't come away. When you open up, natural. Using several methods, scientific and traditional.
No, God.
My other girl, the way you put her in, let you put it. I don't want to.
President General, isn't it the human hero?
God, amen.
All right, okay, Matana, this guy, this money would be able to go. What do you think? Not to say involvement, no other thing.
Yes.
Then, in brief, under 30 seconds, why he will need to? And then, why he will need to go to the
hospital? I am not a man American, and the youth. Now, how medication could die? Naked, never chin naked. And they can ever, the youth, isn't it? And Dr. Doro, Kadia Mayara, and no one they can see you are. I am Kucha and I am Kuene in the Mareba, organizing it for one day. And I had you, why you are all for Choya Dana, meaning you can have one day. Shana Makena, Kasim, Nazu, actually, because they are an arch.
Yeah. Okay, and don't worry, people, because the crime scene, okay, and don't mind the man, commander, as the commander of Oga, under 30 seconds, why he will be beside this here? One of the, nah, is in Ila.
Yeah, man, boom. One of them, Peruga, Ure. And where you home, man, Doga? And that was going to be not sure I come back. I'm out of my game with you. And where you hear you try, she think of your man better.
Now, on 100 copies, you're handling.
I got handed over to police.
Chairman, Umeh Oga, same plan, the secret, Chairman, Secretary Umeh Oga, in the person of Chief Stephen, is the one for. So, what's your guru? Is the one for?
No.
Because I want my dear son when you're with him. And they bring him in 1 hour, I say. Under 30 seconds, where he will go. None of that.
Because he ain't men in a low guy. I am one of y'all for the way, but who is? I want the high camp, Macamiona, which is the Royals or Ladis. But I took him a better time. Mr. Name Bambon, I would go Ghana no way. It will win the million. Otherwise, no guy, or when you'll be the man when you get the Meroy and Yomera. When I thought that you will go to go, you will do it. Oh, he ended. I get confused.
Yeah, but before now,
I'm going
before now.
Yeah,
so,
I was
watching
the same one.
Okay, man, thank you so much. in the person of a chief,
yeah, this one,
Anthony,
the one that forced to thank God,
PhD, and the person to the general for getting prophet, you know. Unfortunately, he has never seen this kind of thing. Please, don't be offended. I want you to say this in English so that all of something we understand what is happening. In less than 30 seconds, I thank God that one of the centuries of okay, you, in the person of a chief, if I look here, I can look on Oga, is also here, and the others here, Commander Ogunwese, and the chairman, I ask you to the Premier League. And then also, Zafa, Akai, thank you so much. Akunaka, thank you. I'm Rafi, may they pass a PG, VG commander. Now, PG, Omogiburu, thank you. And by the grace of God, all this while you have not been sleeping, Oga has not been sleeping, because this is a heinous crime. A gruesome murder that took the life of a 13 months pregnant woman away and caused a chaos between Oga and this victim. Please, under 30 seconds, you have heard from the duty of his and other people. Tell us what you have to say. Under 30 seconds.
I don't know whether I should start crying. My heart aches. Oga people are not known for this kind of acts. Amarando Oga. There are these ancient adage that says, Oga will battle. And to confirm this young man, Aburu Onyoga, this young man, Onyat, the record should be straight. No, Oga had a mood over man, but they are living in homeless. This is an unfortunate situation. I'm not being myself. The young lady, she's now lying lifeless in the mortuary. Life was sweet. I don't have to. If I say I should thank God, I'm still mourning. But in everything, I must thank God. I must comment the efforts of the security. Chief Asom has spoken. The commander, Patrick Romale, has spoken. None of them has rested since then. Most importantly, amiable and
grammar. Our people and the grammar.
More than vibrant. Youth leader. He is the overall youth leader in the entire town. Followed by him is another youth leader in one of the villages. There is a youth leader of ours community where the mother took this and the village of the victim. There are others. I will not itemize what they did, but the hand of God has been with them. God will bless them one by one. Your time. Everything they invested to ensure that the image of this is avenged. I must commend the understanding of the present general of Islam. He's a nice man. If not, another victim, perhaps the husband of the victim, would have been murdered by now. Because there's many
speculations,
viral information,
speculations,
unverified information in the social media.
Speculations.
The women folk went on demonstration. That of Uga. They went to Zim. As if they come to us. They went to you, but they only come to me.
So, you see my people. Una honyen neku mmadu gburu mmadu Megide, Megide, Ogbaghara di n'obodo, between Oga and Ezinifte. Megide, ha chọpụta onye gburu di mmadụ. Ha na-ekele Chineke na na Chineke egosigo ihe o ji bụrụ Chineke. Chukwu egosigo ihe o ji bụrụ Chukwu. Bai ka e chọta onye mere ihe a. Kedu ebe Chineke a ma Chukwu a nọ mgbe o gburu that lady? Some of them believe no the especially women. You see, our women in our villages, their mouth is poisonous. Somebody say that our people, their problem is 2 inches below their nose. They snitch and they poke nose and they, you see them begin to talk what they don't know. You buy a car, he's a thief. He's a courtesy. Just because you make money, he's in the car. Yeah. Every time these people run their mouth without fact, and that's why they are Christians. These people are Christians, including the murderer. There is his name. God is in his name. But he killed this young lady because of phone, telephone. See, this is my old phone. This is my new phone. He killed somebody, and the phone he killed that person may not be even iPhone. It may be just one toy phone, but he want to have phone, and he killed that guy. And you see, Oga and Ezinifte wanted to fight. Now this guy, the last guy that spoke, said that this guy is from Achina. Now you want to cause anything with Achina too? All of us are one. None of us. Somebody say this type of thing is it doesn't happen in Oga. It's a lie. There's nothing that is happening in another village that is not happening in your village. But we keep lying to ourselves. Instead of standing up to fix our problem, we're hiding it. We're pampering it. And believing that one God will save it or we make a way, somehow it will be solved. No, let us wake up, my people. There is no God that helped them to catch this guy. It was the effort of people, the security people, and they did their job. And good job. But they should trash God out of their system. It's like Nnamdi Kanu. You see, Nnamdi Kanu, when he talk about Biafra, I clap for him. But when he start talking about Elohim, Chukwuka Abiyama, all those Israel bullshit, Bible bullshit, I put him aside. Get out. I don't need that bullshit. Talk like human beings. Human beings don't need God. All we need is ourselves to fix our problem. You may be blaming that young man, but if you see the condition of our people in our village, maybe one of his mates come from the city with phone, bragging, okay, this guy saying one phone. You know how much they pay him to cut palm fronds? That's what he will use to buy such phone this lady was having. He was coming from work, so he was not a lazy man. But he killed this lady because of phone. He's God-fearing too. She's God-fearing too. But this God let him kill her. This God did not show up. And people will need to find, who did this? Who did this? God did not reveal who killed it. Security people, they begin to... Perhaps, maybe they went to a native doctor, said, this person did it. Quote me, it must be a native doctor that revealed who killed that woman. Not any God, not any Jesus, not any pastor, not any man of God. Native doctor. Oga also have, I met one of them. When he tell you something, it is so, I will share his video with you, videos with him. So my people, why can't you think and help yourself? God cannot help us. You see the bad road in our place. You see the condition of our villages. Our youth don't fix road anymore as we used to, at least it'd be trackable. Roads are no longer trackable. The Appian ways you used to go is no longer trackable. But people are building houses everywhere. Money they made from the city, money they made from abroad, not in the village. Why can't we make money in our village? Oh, we are in America saying that. Stupid. I just came back from my village. And if it's, I can go back to my village today. I'm not running away from my village. My village is better than America. But the American government is better than the government that is over my village. That's why I am in America. Do you get that? My plan for coming to America was never to come to live permanently in America. It's to come and gain that access, and I have it as an American citizen. To relocate to my village is not a problem to me. I can do that, and I've shown that I can do that even before coming to America. I'm not a city person. I know my nature, and I'm not running away from it. It's time we think and have everything. Let us stop being book people. All these people talking about God, Chukwu, Jesus, in Jesus' name, is because of this book of the law, say so. It's not because they know what they are saying. The man say, I am grieved, you know, I don't need to thank God, but they're saying everything, thank God. See, faith kills your sense of reasoning. Says, faith kills your brain. Says, make you unable to think as a human being. And that's what religion wants you to be doing. How long will you continue in religion? You can tag them on this. You can share it with them. Let them listen. We have to wake up and begin to work on ourselves and for ourselves. Work on ourselves and work for ourselves. That's the way we can free ourselves from bondage of religion and politics. Peace.